JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for June the 3rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the financial community traded in a risk-on manner yesterday as major EU and US shares traded in the green. The only exception was Spain's IBEX 35, which slid 0.10%. The appetite eased somewhat today during the Asian session, with Japan's Nikkei 225 and South Korea's KO SPI gaining 0.39 and 0.84% respectively. But China, Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng losing 0.10 and 0.72%. It seems that market participants were a bit more comfortable adding to their risk exposure a couple of days before the US employment report for May. That said, despite the latest improvement in market sentiment, we prefer to step to the sidelines as today, ahead of tomorrow's NFPs, we have the initial jobless claims for last week and the ISM non-manufacturing index for May. Initial jobless claims are expected to continue declining to 390,000 from 406,000, while the ISM index is anticipated to have increased to 63 from 62.7. With the core PCE index, the Fed's favorite inflation metric surging to 3.1% year over year from 1.9%. The ISM manufacturing index climbing to 61.2 from 60.7. And some officials sharing the view that the committee should start discussing policy normalization at its upcoming meetings. More signs that the economy and the labor market are improving are likely to weigh on equities, especially on high-growth tech firms. Yesterday, Philadelphia President Patrick Harker joined the group of officials supporting quantitative easing tapering, which means that with more upbeat US data, the chances for policy normalization will increase. Faster QE tapering means interest rates could rise sooner as well, which may raise concerns about the discounted present values of the aforementioned growth stocks as they are mainly valued based on earnings expected years into the future. At the same time, the US dollar is likely to rebound. That said, for that market reaction to last for a while longer, the US employment report for May due out tomorrow may have to come on the strong side as well. Non-farm payrolls are expected to have accelerated to 650,000 from 266,000, something supported by the forecast of the ADP report, which is scheduled to be released today. However, history has shown that the ADP number is far from a reliable predictor of the NFPs, and perhaps that's why the market barely responds to it. In any case, the unemployment rate is expected to have declined to 5.9% from 6.1%, while average hourly earnings are expected to slow to 0.2% month over month from 0.7%. Nonetheless, this will drive the year-over-year rate up to 1.6% year-over-year from 0.3%, increasing speculation that inflation is likely to continue rising and thereby lead to policy normalization by the Fed. Now, as for the rest of today's events, apart from the initial jobless claims, the ISM non-manufacturing index and the ADP employment report coming out from the US, we also have the final services and composite market PMIs for May from the Eurozone, the UK and the US. However, as it is the case most of the times, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. As for the speakers, we will get to hear from Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic and Fed Governor Randall Quarles. Both sticks sat on the dovish spectrum of the Fed, saying that there is no reason to change policy despite inflation fears, while Quarles signaled that he is open to discuss adjustments to the committee's bond purchase program. With that in mind, it would be very interesting to see what they have to say today. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. At this point, I need to let you know that there will be no daily market review video tomorrow. So goodbye, have a great day, a great rest of the week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.